each of these things are really huge. And some of it has to do with the finances. But the same person appeared to be seeking counsel. I want to encourage you to seek counsel only from those who have greater faith than you. Because if you're seeking counsel from someone whose faith is not as, robust as yours, they're likely going to lead you in the flesh. I want you to take note that what you need to do is to trust God. Immediately the word came, then a song also came along with it. It says, standing on the promises of God that cannot fail. So that is the word for you. Stand on the promise of God and it will not fail. I want each and every one of you to recognize that that word is also for each of us. In whatever area you may be having any challenge now, in whatever area that you may be looking, how am I going to handle this? Stand on the promises of God. Praise the Lord. I didn't think of the song. It just came to me. I woke up with that song. Standing on the promise of God that cannot fail. Praise the Lord. The Lord your God will fulfill his word to you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He's the eternal God. And he did all that he did so that the promises may be fulfilled. So that each of us can live the kind of life that he wants us to live in him. So let us trust him. Praise the Lord. So you can turn to somebody next to you and just encourage them and tell them, trust the Lord. Just trust the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We're grateful to God for today. Amen. We've been looking at a word that I believe is the pillar of our faith. But we have to, at some point, turn to something else. So I want to seize this opportunity to round up, and that is why I am happy today that the youths are here so that we can hear fundamental truths, which is going to impact our lives as long as we're living on this earth. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I want to tell you that there is an hierarchy of authority. There is an hierarchy of authority. Everyone that lives on earth is to live under authority. Amen. I want you to please listen to me very carefully. I'm not here to fight you. Some of the things you hear may not appear to be exactly what you want to hear, but I want to tell you that it is the truth. And if something is the truth, we know that the scripture has told us that nobody can do anything against the truth but for the truth. That means that we cannot run away from it. That means we have to deal with it. Praise the Lord. There is hierarchy of authority. And we come into recognition or awareness of that hierarchy in different ways. So it's not even the highest authority that we recognize first. In terms of hierarchy, the Almighty God is the number one authority in the entire universe because he created all things. Praise the Lord. Amen. And when you're talking of the Almighty God, you also let your mind go to Jesus Christ. Because the Bible says that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was with God in the beginning. He said, all things were made by him. That this is the Creator. And he said, without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and that life is the light of men. Praise the Lord. So we have to recognize the Almighty God and our Lord Jesus Christ as having supreme authority over all creation. Praise the Lord. next to the Almighty God are his representatives. He said, those who receive me, they receive, those who receive you, they receive me. And those who receive me, they receive my Father who has sent me. Praise the Lord. So it is not that they put themselves there. That is what the word of God said. Because we know that a representative of a person speaks for that person and speaks in his place. Amen. And the word that representative speaks must also be respected as the word of the one that has sent him. Glory be to God. So that is why we have to recognize that the servants of God that he has truly sent unto us are the ones we are to listen to. They have authority over us. The Bible told us to obey them. Not obey them as in the flesh, but to obey them as they teach us spiritual things and counsel us. There was a testimony that a man of God gave that I had many years ago. There was one of the church leaders working with him. And the sister of this church worker had been expecting the fruit of the womb for many years and now became pregnant and delivered a baby. So he was eager to go and celebrate the birth of the child of the sister, since the entire family had been looking forward to the sister having a child for many, many years. So he went to tell his pastor and said, I would like to go and have, you know, celebrate the christening of this child. And the pastor said, no, don't go. He walked out of the office of the pastor, took a friend of his, and insisted that he had to go, and got in the car and drove and never got to the place he was going. He died on the way. He died in that journey. Praise the Lord. Amen. He died because of disobedience. Sometimes these servants of God speak. The word they speak is put in their mouths by God. They may not even know why they are saying the things that they say. I have an example that happened a few years ago. There was a young man that came to me and said some things before me, and I told him not to do a specific thing. And then he went out, and I started asking myself, this is ridiculous. How will you tell him not to do this thing which you said to him that he shouldn't do? So it didn't make sense to me. The instruction I gave to him did not make sense to me. He went out. He did what I said he should not do and was afflicted with a plague. And now ran back a few days later. Pastor, this is what is happening. That was when I myself understood the reason why I told him not to do what he did. Praise the Lord. When we receive word from an authority figure, it is to give us peace in our lives. And it is to ensure that we avoid the troubles of life and the storms of life. There are many counsels that we have given that people have not listened to. And we have seen the result of that disobedience. And unfortunately, there is nothing we can do about it. Praise the Lord. There was a young man not long ago. The Lord showed me a vision that he should be very careful not to have a police issue. And I called the father, who happens to be close to me. And I told his father, this is what I saw. Tell your son, no matter what happens, he needs to be very, very careful. And the son dismissed what the father said and just walked away. A few weeks later, was driving, and then there was somebody pursuing him somehow, got out of his car and started talking to this elderly person. Why are you following me? There was a little altercation. There was no problem. He got into his car and was driving again. The man kept on following him and then got angry, got out of his car again. Instead of just going home, took the glasses of the man and, you know, just to distract him. And the police came. It was a big case. And The case ended in a plea bargain that affected his life for 5 years. 5 years. Praise the Lord. I want you to understand that God is an authority figure. Those ones that he has sent to you, they are authority figures. Please listen to them. Praise the Lord. It is all for our benefit. Next to those that God has sent to us are our parents. Our parents are authority figures over our lives. Many of us, we have run into troubles because we did not obey our parents. Amen. Listen to them. God has brought them to be a guide for each of us. You may not like what they say, but follow their instructions because in it is your peace. When I was young and I was in high school, my mother would often tell me that education is not wisdom. And I just couldn't figure it out. I said, what's she talking about? I was very good in my studies, so I thought that was what wisdom was all about. Praise the Lord. You know, you score A's, you're number one everywhere. So it's like, what is this woman talking about? She doesn't know what she's talking about. I'm sure many of you, you're looking at us today as if we don't know what we're talking about. We were like that when we were your age. But we learned. So the word that you are hearing today is to impact your life. God put parents in your life to build you up and to train you so that his purpose may be fulfilled in your life, so that you may live a life of peace and prosperity. And that shall be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm standing before you as your pastor. There are three things I regret that my father told me not to do that I did. Thank God he didn't impact my life in two adverse manner. Praise the Lord. Amen. Three things that he told me. He has told me many things that I've done. But there were three things he told me not to do. And I did those three things. And when I look back, they constitute blemishes in my life. If I had listened, it would have been different. Praise the Lord. So we need to learn. We need to learn. Your parents are guiding you. They give you instructions. Please, please follow their instructions. The Bible told us in Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8. Let's look at Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8. The Bible says, though he were a son, he learned obedience. I want you to say, he learned obedience.
He learned obedience.
So obedience is to be learned. It's to be learned. So if it is to be learned, it has to be taught. That means that none of us have capacity without learning it. And it also implies that we don't want it. There are very few people who are normally obedient. When we were growing up those days, they would tell us to sweep the floor. We'd be wondering why is it that they are bothering us? They would tell us, go and wash your plate. It's like it's a big, big mountain. Why should I have to wash my plate? I couldn't wash plates for many, many years. And in fact, at the time I started, you know, sharing an apartment or a room with a friend of mine, our agreement was that, well, you wash the plates and I'll cook the food, because I hated washing plates. Praise God. And he couldn't cook, so it was a great partnership. Amen. So I will cook. Amen. Yes, division of labor. And then he will go and wash the plates. I hated washing my clothes and was mine. I hated it. I didn't want to wash my clothes. Praise God. There are many other things we hated, some of us that are here, that we can't even talk in public. Glory be to God. There were some those days, they hated brushing their teeth. He said, go and brush your teeth. It's like it's going to be a commotion. For 15 minutes, a teeth you will brush in 3 seconds. Praise God. So he learned obedience. And how did he learn this obedience? The Bible says, through what? He did what? He suffered. Glory be to God. He learned obedience through what he suffered. Amen. Glory be to God. Also, being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation unto all them that do what? Is it unto all? Is it just unto all? All? No. Unto all that obey him. So even eternal life is not possible without obedience. Salvation is not possible without obedience. So obey your parents. Obey your parents. What they ask you to do, do it. They are constituted as authority figure over you by God. Praise the Lord. Most parents will probably pray for a male or a female child. But there is no way they can describe that child perfectly. It is God that gives. I told you that I'm a man of faith. I walk by faith. One day I woke up, somebody told me that's your mother, and another person told me that's your father. And I said, yes, it takes faith. Because I was not there when I was born. I was not conscious. I didn't see that was this is the father I was coming to. This is the mother that bore me. No, I just became conscious and somebody stood before me and said, I'm your mother. I said, yes, I believe you. Praise the Lord. Another said, I'm your father. I said, yes, I believe you. So we have been creatures of faith. So God is the one that does this thing. You are a child of that man because God made it so. You are a daughter or a son of that woman because God made it so. So stop saying, look, who is this woman? Why am I not in this house? Why should this be my mother? Why should this be my father? It's your father. It's your mother. But obey their voices. Praise the Lord. The Bible says that if you obey their voices, if you obey them, that your days shall be long in the land that the Lord your God has given you. That means when you obey your parents, you are buying yourself long life. Praise the Lord. Amen. You live long by obeying your parents. Many children have died through disobedience. Through disobedience. Things that they've told them don't do, and then they go and do it, and that is what resulted in their death. That's why you have to just obey your parents. Just obey your parents. Because we've been talking about obedience. You know, what God did, if we look at what the scripture and we stand back and meditate, we realize that in an attempt to bring us to himself, so that we begin to relate with him as obedient children, he placed us in certain situations before we knew him to learn obedience. One of those situations is in family. He put you there so that you can learn obedience. Because when you relate with God, when you become aware of God, conscious of God, and you invite him into your life, it is obedience that will bring the blessings in your life. So what you have gone through is training. It's training. Praise the Lord. Obey your parents. Listen to them. Don't argue. You may not understand what they are saying. Particularly, sometimes they may be, you know, I mean, how do you explain when a parent tells you this person you have brought home is not a good person for you? And he or she never met your friend ever. They've never met. He has not heard anything about him or her. Your mother does not know, has never even heard his name or her name. I say, what is he talking about? He just says, my friend. There is something in them. There is something in them that is guiding you. Praise the Lord. My father told me once and looked at my friend, about almost 15 of them, and told me, these are not your friends. I just looked at him. You don't know what you are talking about. Today, I realized they were not my friends. Praise the Lord. I realized they were not my friends. There were sufferings that I could have been saved from if I listened to my father. But I thought it was wrong. Praise the Lord. Listen to them. The next authority figure, which you will probably encounter, praise the Lord. Amen. Apart from parents, are husbands. And I want you wives to listen. I'm not here telling you the things that I dreamt of myself. The Bible tells us, wives, submit unto your own husband. When you look at the word submit and obey, it's the same thing. Praise the Lord. All right? Submit unto your own husband. And if you're still confused about what it means, it says, as unto the Lord. Now, ask yourself, how do I submit unto the Lord? Is it by arguing with him? Is it by saying, no, that's what you think, and I'm not going to do it? This is the United States of America. No, you don't do that. You submit, you respect your own husband. That's what the Bible says. It is not my word. It is what our father says. Praise the Lord. Amen. When the wife disobeys the husband or does not submit to the husband, he's teaching the children not to submit. Praise God. We need to see the concept of God in the things that he is doing. This feminist thing is not of God. I don't know the other opposite. What is the opposite of that? Masculine is not of God. Yes, if a person, male chauvinism is not of God. Praise the Lord. We should just listen to the word of God, what he's saying. While he says, wives, submit to your own husband, he said husbands should also love their wives. So God is not partial. He's your father. He cannot be partial. He cannot be enslaving you to others. No. He said your wife should, your husband should love you. I mean, is that not a good father? He's a good father. But he says, submit to your own husband. He's an authority figure over you. That's it. Why did God do that? Maybe when we get there, we will ask him. Praise the Lord. And you know that this is consistent. Because when he made the man, he said, I will make for him a woman that is meet for him. A helper that is meet for him. So now, if you are a helper, are you going to take the whole responsibility on yourself and fail to listen to the one you are helping? How do you know how you are going to help a person without listening to the person of what he wants to do? Praise God. Say, for example, I bring out a pail. And all I want to do is to just put the pail somewhere. And you think that it has to be filled with water because it's a bucket. And you take it and you fill it with water. Will that serve my interest? No. Praise God. So what we need is for us to take our eyes from the world and put it on the word of God. Amen. What the world is teaching is not what God wants us to learn. Amen? It is what he is teaching that he wants us to learn. A woman that submits to her own husband loses nothing. I told you that, you know, by the grace of God, through observation, I've seen so many things. When I was growing up, usually, I came from a very large family. So you know that there must be issues sometimes. So whenever there is an issue, you see the elders sit down. And the older women will sit with them because they want to discuss the issue. I'm speaking to you about the benefit of wives submitting to their own husband. And when they want to talk about these things and they want to round it up, they never bypass the women. And they call them the mother of the house. That's the title they call them. Because they have been submissive in the family. They have worked together with the family to raise the people. So they have a voice in the family. A woman that submits to her husband has a voice in the family. This modern age that we're looking at, that is driving our actions, is driving us from the will of God. And we need to turn back. You lose nothing by submitting to your own husband. Because that's what the Bible says. Praise the Lord. Amen. You submit to your own husband as unto the Lord. Let's read Ephesians chapter 5. Husbands also are authority figures. Fathers and mothers are authority figures. And this is to encourage us so that we may know how to behave. We may know how to behave in the house of God. Praise the Lord. Verse 22. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husband as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife. Is that what is in your own Bible? Only one person saw it. The others are still looking for it. Praise the Lord. We're talking of the mothers, to the mothers in the house. Please open to Ephesians chapter 5. We're reading from verse 22. I want to know whether what I'm reading is correct or not. It says, wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands. Unto your own husband. Not to another person's husband. Unto your own husband. As unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife. Is that in your own Bible? I don't think we need to say anything more. The husband is the head of the wife. So let us recognize that authority figure and be submissive. But the men should not also forget that in this scripture, the Bible also said, husbands, love your own wives. We are not military officers in our own homes. Amen. The Bible says for them to recognize our authority, but we then don't go there and start issuing orders without, taking into consideration the feelings of others. It also presupposes that we are godly people, amen, willing to be administered and governed and directed by the word of God ourselves. Praise the Lord. Amen. Now, when you look at this authority figure, you also realize that government is one of them. And this is very important. If you don't learn to obey your parents, if you don't learn to submit to your parents, you're likely to have problem with the law. If you do not receive instructions from your parents and submit under their authority, you are likely to have problems submitting to governmental authorities. For example, they will tell you, this is the speed limit. You will say, no, they can't tell you that because I'm in a hurry. You're not submitting. Praise God. Amen. They may tell you should not park in a certain place. And you tell yourself, what are they saying? This place is closest to where I'm going, and I'm only going to be there for 5 minutes. And you disagree with that authority, and you park there. Praise the Lord. I've seen here in the United States of America some very disturbing things that I want you to listen to. I've seen a person who has allowed his life to be terribly, negatively affected from a parking ticket. From a parking ticket. Got a parking ticket. First of all, should not park there. Received a ticket. Refused to pay. And then the thing kept on increasing until his license was suspended. Amen. And then one day he got to work. This was many years ago. Got to work. and was fired because they cited that, look, you can't work. You have a suspended license. And he said, no, I didn't have a suspended license. Okay, go and check it out. When you get the truth, come back to us. And he found out that he was on a suspended license. This person began to receive this thing they give them for food. Food stamp. From one ticket. Praise God. Children, please understand what we're talking about. One ticket, one parking ticket led a person to full stamp. A person that was fully engaged, fully employed, taking care of his family, now could not cater unto his own family. Carelessness and refusal to listen to constituted authority. There are many that are in trouble because they refuse to file their taxes. The Bible tells us, give unto Caesar things that are Caesar's and unto God the things that are God's. Amen? You cannot do this. And you are able to submit to governmental authority when you have been used to submitting to parental authority. So when government issues an instruction, you don't say, well, they are saying their own. Because you have been used to disobedience. So if you are used to disobedience, you carry on disobedience and it can affect your entire life. There are people that have ended up in jail for very little thing. Small things. That is really, when you look at it, you say, why should this be? Why should this be? We must all learn obedience. Look at Hebrews chapter 13. Romans 13. Look at Romans 13. You must learn obedience. Turn to somebody and say, you must learn obedience. Say to them again, you must learn obedience. It is for your own good. Praise the Lord. Romans chapter 13. Romans chapter 13. Are you following what you are hearing today? Praise God. I know you don't like it because the response shows me you don't like it, but it's the truth. You have to hear it. Praise the Lord. Amen. The Bible says, let every soul be subject unto what? That is higher authority. That's why he used the word hierarchy of authority. Let every soul be subject unto higher power. Praise the Lord. For there is no power but of what? Of God. The powers that be are ordained of God. Glory be to God. Whosoever therefore resisted the power, resisted the ordinance of God, and what? And they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. They that resist, when you refuse the authority, obey the law. Say to somebody, obey the law. Say to somebody, obey the law. You know, I've shown you how a person disobeyed the pastor and died. There are people who disobey the law and they die. Say, when you drive, don't drink. Is that not the law? When I first came to the United States of America, within 2 months, I attended the funeral of a very young man. Very young man, just a year out of high school. Very handsome. He got drunk, got into his car, crashed, and died. If he had obeyed that law, he would still be alive. Praise the Lord. So obedience delivers you from death. That is why he said your life will be prolonged when you obey. Amen? So we need to see these things and know that God is telling us something here. You know, he showed to us from scripture that is everything. He himself had to obey to be able to finish the plan of salvation. And we cannot receive that plan or benefit from that plan without obedience. So obedience is everything. He submitted himself and became obedient unto death, even the death on the cross, so that we may receive the benefit. So it's important for us to know that obedience is not something that is against us. Obedience is for our benefit. Glory be to God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Another authority group are employers. If you look at the scripture, it will say, servants, obey your masters in the, you know, in the flesh. That is, employees obey the employers. You don't go to the place of work and start telling them, this is the way you run this place, contrary to policy. When you go contrary to policy, it creates problems. Praise the Lord. I was in a management position several years ago, and we sat down, the top management, about the pricing of our products. And then we made some formulations, and you know, the executive chairman was there, the vice chairman was there, the deputy executive chairman was there, the general manager was there, I was there as assistant group assistant general manager, group assistant general manager, and there was another person there, assistant general manager. We sat down to formulate policy. One of us was a Greek man who was in charge of marketing, left after the meeting and just immediately priced the product on his own and issued a bulletin on the prices. 5 minutes after he did that, he was fired. He was an assistant general manager marketing. He was from Greece. Praise the Lord. 5 minutes after he did that, he was fired. Because how can we sit down? And that was the question that the executive chairman asked him. How can we sit down and we have a meeting and you get out of the meeting and you unilaterally took a decision? Does it mean that we wasted our time? He said, you know, it's time for you to go. And he sent me after him. He said, see that he gets out of that office. I was the one that was saddled with the responsibility of ensuring that he packed his things and he left the place. Why? He decided to do what he thinks. Praise the Lord. To your employer, you present your own opinion. If they receive it, it works. If they don't receive it, it doesn't. They tell you to come at 8 or at 9. You don't go to work late. They have policies. This is the policy that is governing the operations of this company. You don't violate that policy and expect to keep your job. Because when you violate the policy, you are saying that the authority does not matter. And they understand the way their business is to run. They have determined their own policies. And most of the time, they are smart. Praise the Lord. And if you even want to change those policies, you have to work with them and be able to present your own views. Glory be to God. Every organization has a procedure for handling everything. Praise the Lord. In those days, we write system manual for organizations. This is the man that is going to approve this up to this level. And the other one will take it, and two signatures are required to approve this amount of expenditure. And you get there, you sign, and you say, well, you do your own stuff. You may lose your job. You lose your job, you lose income. You lose income, it affects your entire life. It affects your status. It affects your ability, what you can do financially. All because you think you're smarter than everybody. Don't do that. Glory be to God. Amen. Look at Colossians chapter 3. We must respect authority figures. We must respect authority figures. And we must make sure that we comply with the godly instructions that they give us. And if an instruction violates your faith, you know, politely, you can look for another place and then leave that organization. Look at verse 22. The Bible says, servants, obey them, obey in all things. Obey in how many things? Your masters, according to the flesh. He's talking of employers. Servants, he's talking of employees. How do we know he's talking of them? Look at it. He said, not with eye service or as men please us, but in singleness of heart, fearing God. And whatever you do, do it heartily as unto the Lord. That is, when you're working, be diligent in your work. Don't let your work be sloppy. Do diligent work. Be zealous. Praise the Lord. Amen. Whatever you do, do it heartily as unto the Lord, and not unto men, knowing that of the Lord ye shall receive the reward of the inheritance. For ye serve the Lord Christ. Praise the Lord. Amen. So serve. When you are an employee in a place, especially as a Christian, they should know that you are a different worker. You should work for the progress of the organization. You should work for the blessing of the organization. You should work for the prosperity of the organization. Don't join some people who will clock in, and I mean, who ask people to clock in for them when they are not at work. Don't do that. Praise God. Don't perform substandard service. Don't put in 6 hours of work for 8 hours of pay. It's not good. It's not going to help in the end. So the Bible says to submit unto them. Praise the Lord. Another authority figure are teachers. Your teachers. They are authority figures over you. And when he says teachers, it doesn't mean that when you are in elementary or high school or college alone. Praise the Lord. Anyone that teaches you, anyone that is teaching you, you cannot learn unless you submit. You cannot learn unless you submit. And this person that is teaching you knows something more than you. And what he's teaching you is planting into you so that you may be better than who you are at the moment. Praise the Lord. Some of you that have left elementary school, I'm sure you have come to look and realize that, yes, I learned some things those days, but what I have now is better than that time. Why? Because you listen to your teachers. When they say to do your homework, you don't do your homework, it's going to affect your performance. You shouldn't be rude to your teachers. You shouldn't ignore their instructions. You shouldn't tell them off because they say, well, you know, the law says they can't touch me, they can't do anything. I am not in Africa where they can, cane me, so I am just going to do what I want. No, obey your teachers. Listen to them. They're teaching you what is beneficial. They're teaching you what will help you. The discipline they're giving you in the things that you are doing is building you up. It's sowing seeds of character in you. That is why you have to obey them. Praise God. When they tell you, and in the United States of America, some of us can't even see why is it that students will find it difficult to obey teachers. We came from a place where, you know, in addition to all the things you do in class, we do a lot more. They will tell us to go and cut wood from the bush and bring to school to make the fence of our school. We were the one cutting the grass of our school. We were the ones carrying and cleaning the compound. You just walk into class, everything is clean, and you can't even pack your own books and clean your own desk. Huh? That's being spoiled. Praise God. Are you here? Praise God. So be obedient to your teachers. If you're rude to your teachers, I've heard of kids that beat up their teachers. And the teachers can't do anything because the law does not allow them to be able to respond. When you do that, you're working against God's instructions. And it's not good. Disobedience will bring one to failure. I'm not talking of academic failure. I'm talking of failure in life. Praise the Lord. If we cannot learn discipline from the small age, when we are young, if we don't learn discipline, we cannot learn it when we are elders. Praise the Lord. If you see an old man behaving funny, it's because he didn't learn obedience from when he was growing up. And you see them. You cannot see a person whose life is structured, who you could look at and say, this man can be emulated, that does not learn obedience. They're disciplined because they have learned obedience. They're responsible because they have learned obedience. Praise the Lord. They're trustworthy because they have learned obedience. Glory be to God. They are dependable because they have learned obedience. If your teacher tells you to do something, they cannot rely on you. If your parents tell you to do something, they cannot rely on you. You're building a habit that is not good. Praise the Lord. Learn to take responsibility. Learn to accept responsibility. Learn to take it upon yourself, even when it has not been given to you. It helps you. It helps you. Praise the Lord. Amen. When you were in the house, I said to some people, I don't know, maybe it was one Friday, the way we were brought up is, nobody tells us anything about what is normal. Our parents will just come home and say, don't you know that you ought to have swept this place? Amen. We may have arranged the room. We may have washed the plates. Praise the Lord. We may have even swept other places in the house. They point out to us the exception. What are you doing that you didn't sweep this place? That's as if you didn't do anything. So sometimes you could say it's discouraging, but it helped us. It helped us to be able to spot things that are wrong and things that need to be fixed. And that is why we can look at your life and see the things that we can do to help you in that area of your life. That's how those trainings come from. That's why it comes. When you can see, that's why you are able to see tiny, tiny little things that are off the normal. And then you can put it right or arrange for somebody to put it right. Praise the Lord. It is important that we be obedient to all these authorities. Amen. We're talking of God Almighty. We're talking of pastors and church leaders. We're talking of parents. We're talking of husbands. We're talking of a government. We're talking of employers. We're talking of teachers. Praise the Lord. These authority figures, that's the way they are. But we come into them, we become aware of them in different ways. The first authority level that we become aware of are the parents. Even though God Almighty is the ultimate authority figure, the first authority figure we are conversing are the parents. Then teachers, because from your home you go to school and they start teaching you. And then from there you start, as you're growing, you begin to become aware of governmental authority. Praise God. And then the rest depends upon the way you choose your life. To some, after governmental authority, if they still don't know the Lord, it may be their husband. And then there are problems because they don't even have any, means of knowing how to relate in those situations, except they are trained by their parents that, no, this is what you do with your husband. Glory be to God. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. So these are the things. Some is the employers because they just finished school. They have not yet known the Lord. And the next authority level they encounter is their employer. So how we encounter these authority figures depends on the way our lives, go. But that is the hierarchy. It has to be God, the servants of God, those who are representing God, our parents, then the government, then, talking of employers and, so on and so on. Praise the Lord. Husbands, government, and so on and so on. Praise the Lord. Now, there is an important fact for us to understand. When you respect your teachers, when you respect your parents, when you respect your employers, when you respect your husbands, praise the Lord, when you respect all of these ones, you are actually honoring God. Because we have seen all the things we have said, we have, you know, quoted scriptures, which is the word of God. So when you obey them, you are actually obeying God. When you obey your parents, you are obeying God. When you obey the government, you are obeying God. When you obey your teachers, you are obeying God. When you submit to your husband, you are obeying God. So therefore, by obedience to these authority figures, we are actually obedient to God. Praise the Lord. And if we are obedient to God, he said, if they are willing and obedient, they will eat the good of the land. Praise the Lord. That is, the land will be yielding of his blessings unto you. It says, if they obey and serve him, they will spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasure. God is saying, when you are obedient, you will prosper. When you are obedient, your life will be comfortable. Praise the Lord. That is what he's saying. He said, if you diligently, you know, obey the voice of the Lord your God to do all these things I've commanded you this day, then he said, the Lord your God will cause these blessings to come upon you and to overtake you. So when you are obedient, you are actually walking in the commanded blessing of God. Let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 28. Praise the Lord. There is great benefit in obedience. There is great benefit in obedience. So don't think that, well, I don't have to obey my parents, but I'm going to obey God. Don't have to obey my teachers, I'm going to obey God. When you don't obey your parents, you are not obeying God. When you don't obey your teachers, you are not obeying God. But when you obey all of them, as God puts you in contact with them, then you are obeying God. And as you obey God, here are the benefits. Look at it. And it shall come to pass in that, look at that, and it shall come to pass if ye shall hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandment, which I command you, I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. You see that? And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, if thou shalt hearken unto the Lord, unto the voice of the Lord thy God. Blessed shalt thou be in the city, and blessed shalt thou be in the field. Praise the Lord. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy ground, and the fruit of thy cattle. Praise the Lord. The increase of thy kind, and the flock of thy sheep. Blessed shalt thou be. Blessed are thy baskets and thy store. Praise the Lord. Blessed shall thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shall thou be when thou goest out. Glory be to God. Are you seeing the benefits of all these things? Praise the Lord. The Lord shall cause thine enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come out against thee one way and flee before thee. How many ways? Seven ways. Glory be to God. The Lord shall command the blessing upon thee in thy storehouses and in all that thou eatest, putteth thy hand. Praise the Lord. In all that thou putteth thy hand. Amen. And he shall bless thee in the land wherein the Lord thy God giveth thee. The Lord shall establish thee. Oh, mokosoto riende rikisabo kayetari anda. The Lord shall establish thee. Praise the Lord. As holy people unto himself. Glory be to God. By obedience, he will say, you are established as a holy people unto himself. Glory be to God. As he has sworn unto thee, If thou shalt keep the commandment of the Lord thy God and walk in all his ways, and all people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of thee. They will never be able to hurt you. They will never be able to harm you. The glory of God will disarm them. Praise the Lord. And the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods. That's talking of prosperity. Praise the Lord. In the fruit of thy body, is repeating again, and in the fruit of thy cattle, and the fruit of thy ground. Praise the Lord. In the land which the Lord thy God sworn unto thy fathers to give thee, the Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure. Open heaven by obedience. Open heaven. Glory be to God. Amen. Look at the benefits. Look at these benefits. Are these not the things that you seek? Are these not the things that you desire? If they are the things you desire and they are the things that you really want, then respect authority figures. Don't think that by dishonoring them, you are right. You cannot be right. Glory be to God. Because God is saying he will command all these blessings on you. He will make sure you live in peace. He will plead your case. Your enemies will not be able to stand up against you. He will put you on top. Amen. You will not have to be struggling about life. You will not have to be struggling about finances. You don't have to be wondering why things are going wrong. Because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Praise the Lord. When he says he will put you on top, that means that you will always be ahead. You will not be behind your peers. Glory be to God. You will be the one they will be looking at. You will be the one they will be emulating by obeying the voice of the Lord your God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. That word, obedience is everything, is true from this passage we're reading. Praise the Lord. Forget about what you think. Receive what God is saying. Forget about what you are hearing out there. In the world, on the television, what you are reading in the newspapers, forget about that. You are not to be guided by that counsel. You are to be guided by this counsel. This is our guide. Praise the Lord. If we desire to walk in prosperity and to walk in peace and to walk in rest, amen, there is a passage in this place that even talks, look at Psalm 112, for example. Generation blessings. That is for you to be blessed, not only you, your family, your children, and their children's children in their generation. Just walk in the obedience of God. Praise the Lord. And as I've said to you, the only way you walk in obedience to God is to walk in obedience to all those things that he said, because that's his word. That's what he's teaching us. Praise the Lord. Psalm 112. Glory be to God. It is foolishness to claim to be seeking something while abandoning the way to it. It is foolishness to claim to desire something and you don't want to go for it. Glory be to God. You hear that this thing you want, you can only get it in New York, and you refuse to go to New York. You keep on driving north to Maine. You enter Canada. And then you go and end up there, maybe Iceland or wherever. And then you are wondering why is it that you don't get the things that is in New York. That is how many people are behaving. They want the blessing. God has told them this is where the blessing is. And they are walking away from it and complaining and wondering why is it I'm not getting the blessing. It's not where you're going. You have to turn back. To get it where it is. Obedience is where the blessing is. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Look at this word. Praise ye. He said, praise ye the Lord. Blessed is the man that does what? Do you know that fearing God is the same thing as obedience? When Abraham obeyed God, when he wanted to sacrifice his son, what does the scripture say? He said, now I know that you feared God. That is, your obedience is proof of your fear of God. So obedience is proof of the fear of God. It's not to lock yourself inside the room and be shaking, and be shivering and be terrified when you don't want to obey him. That's not fair. Glory be to God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Then he said that delighted greatly in his commandment. So we know what the fear of God is, to delight greatly in the commandment of God. And if you delight in the command, what do you want to do? You want to obey. Praise the Lord. Amen. He said his seed, that is his children, shall be mighty. You see, look at the benefit of what we're talking about. His children shall be mighty upon the earth. The generation of the upright shall be blessed. Wealth and riches shall be where? In his house. It won't be a pauper. It won't be a want. It won't lack anything because he is obedient. Praise the Lord. Amen. And then he said, and his righteousness endureth forever. Glory be to God. Unto the upright there ariseth light. That is, light arising for you is that you will never be confused. You always know what to do. You always go forward. Praise the Lord. You will never be mentally stranded. And then they say, well, you can see him. He's a confused man. He doesn't know what he's doing. That will never happen. The Lord will always make a way for you. Glory be to God. Rise upon your feet. The world is teaching many things. But I pray today and I decree today that you shall not be confused. Amen. What the world is teaching to confuse. God is the teacher. He told them, of every fruit of the garden you may freely eat, but of the fruit that is in the midst of the garden, which is the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil, you should not eat it. In the day you eat it, you shall die. That the first teacher of every believer is God. The first teacher you listen to is God, is the instructor. Another one came, amen, of a different breed. As God said, that thou shalt not eat of every tree that is regarding. The end result was that when they listened to him, things didn't end up well. Praise the Lord. We are not called to listen to any but God. We are not called to listen to any but God. Praise the Lord. Any doctrine out there that violates the word of God, any doctrine out there, any teaching that does not agree with the Bible is not something you should be following. Because you follow it, you follow deception, you follow it into ruin. But that shall not be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. We have had this thing. I want each of us to repent. Every instruction your parent has given to you that you have refused, every instruction your teacher has given to you that you have not taken note of, your employers, let us repent. Every instruction from government that we have refused, when you put all these things together, you could see that they have input and impact in our lives. But when we repent, the Lord will restore. Amen. When we repent, the Lord will turn it around. Amen. So I want you to tell the Lord, Lord, forgive me for disobeying your word. Because you are the one that spoke to me to obey my parents. You're the one that said I should obey my employers. You're the one that said I should obey government. You're the one that said I should obey my husband. You're the one, oh Lord God, that said I should obey my teachers. You're the one that said to me, as you obey, O Lord, your servants. He said, those who receive you, they receive me. And those who receive me, they receive my Father who is in heaven. Lord, I pray that you will forgive me for all acts of disobediences that I've engaged in from the beginning until now, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, forgive me in the mighty name of Jesus. I repent. Now I know. Now I understand. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, forgive me, wash away my sins. In the name of Jesus Christ, I give you all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. When God forgives our sins, then he can restore. He can restore all the pains that are associated with those past disobediences. The Lord will remove them and turn us in the right way. Praise the Lord. So let us pray now and ask the Lord to open his blessings upon our lives. Or even before that, let us pray that, Lord, I've opened my heart to you to obey you. From now on, I shall obey my parents. From now on, I shall obey my teachers. From now on, I shall obey my employers. I shall obey the government. In the name of Jesus, strengthen me to obey your word. Strengthen me to obey the word of God. Strengthen me to obey the pastor. Strengthen me, O Lord God Almighty, to obey my husband. In the name of Jesus Christ, having repented, I've turned around and I will do what is right from now on. In the name of Jesus Christ, give me the grace, O Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, help me, my Lord and my God, to walk in obedience with those who are in authority over me. In the mighty name of Jesus, I give you all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The next prayer is for God now to pour his blessings upon your life. Tell the Lord, those things that I've missed because of disobedience, the troubles I've brought myself into because of disobedience, the difficulties that have emerged in my life because of disobedience, Father, remove them and restore me in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your grace and your mercy flow unto me. Open the windows of heaven that your blessings may be upon my life. Begin to pray now in the name of Jesus. Make sure you pray this prayer. Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray, my Father, that all the difficulties, the challenges, and all the pains, all the deprivations that I've suffered because of disobedience, Lord, overturn it in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, Lord, restore me. Refresh me in the name of Jesus. Turn things around for me in the name of Jesus Christ. Give me grace to walk only in your wisdom in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that I may be able to do what is right always in Jesus' name. Father, I ask for this grace in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let me be restored. Pour your blessings upon my life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Enrich me in every good thing. In the name of Jesus Christ, as you have promised in Deuteronomy chapter 28, the blessings upon those who are obedient, let those blessings come upon me because of the precious blood of Jesus. I give you all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father, here are your children. All of us, there is none that can be taken out without exception. I've been disobedient at one time or the other in our lives. I've cited my own example before your people. My Lord and my God, here we are today. We come before you and we repent. Every one of us, young and old, male and female, that Lord, you will forgive us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Be gracious unto us, O Lord, that we may enter into the goodnesses that are in Christ Jesus for us, so that your own glory may be seen upon the earth. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Father, our disobedience has not only affected us, it has affected the manifestation of your glory in our lives. And because of that, it has also affected, O Lord God Almighty, the kingdom of God. Therefore, we pray today that you will remove all, O Lord God, the consequences of the sin in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Wash it away completely. Amen. We repent, each and every one of us, and we turn to the path of obedience today in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. As the Lord Jesus received grace, because he said, I have power to lay down my life and I have power to take it up again. This commandment have I received from my Father. Lord, the grace that he had to lay down his life, release the same grace upon us to obey, O Lord. Amen. Let us obey our teachers. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Grace to obey, my Lord and my God, our employers. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Grace to obey the government. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Grace to obey our husbands. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. Grace to obey our parents. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Grace to obey the servants of God that God has sent unto us. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And grace to obey the Almighty God. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. As you have used all these people to train us in the path of obedience, let us walk in obedience. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Father, we now pray all the consequences of disobedience that may be lingering in our lives because of your mercy, sweep them away.
Amen.
Let a new chapter be open for us today.
Amen.
Let us walk in the blessing.
Amen.
Restore all good things unto us.
Amen.
Restore us into the blessing.
Amen.
Every step we take from now on, let it turn things around for us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ,
Amen.
Grant us the life of peace.
Amen.
Grant us the life of joy.
Amen.
Let us prosper in all things.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If there be any force of the enemy that is operating in our lives because we have been walking in disobedience, you are the one that says that if we obey, then our enemies will not be able to stand up against us. You said we shall be on top always. Therefore, Lord Almighty, in the name of Jesus Christ, disarm the enemies now.
Amen.
Neutralize all the works of darkness.
Amen.
Neutralize all manifestations of the enemy.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ,
Amen.
Command peace for us.
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 Amen.
Let the blood of Jesus, my Lord and my God, bring better things for us now.
Amen.
Lord, I plead the blood of Jesus on each and every one of us. I present the blood of Jesus to you. Every arraignment of the wicked, because of the blood of Jesus, my Lord and my God, I know they have no basis. Therefore, they shall no longer operate in our lives.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
From now, there is joy.
Amen.
There is progress.
Amen.
There is advancement.
Amen.
There is prosperity.
Amen.
There is enlargement.
Amen.
There is comfort.
Amen.
There is increase.
Amen.
There is abundance.
Amen.
There is rest.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let's put our hands together for Jesus. Glory be to God. Amen. Please sit down. Thank the Lord for your lives. Thank God for this word. It shall be with us forever. In the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. I will read from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23. For I received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you. And the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take. Eat this, take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me." After the same manner also, he took the cup when he had supped, saying, New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Praise the Lord. Father, we are grateful to you. We thank you for this great mystery that we cannot fully comprehend, but we understand by the grace that you give unto us. We thank you for the amazing mercies that flow through the communion. We thank you that you presented unto us your word in the beginning, and you presented unto us your body and your blood. There is nothing more sacred. There is nothing more holy. There is nothing more sanctified. There is nothing more purified. There is nothing more powerful that can help us in this journey. We are grateful to you for this amazing blessing. Accept our praises in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Here we are, O Lord, today. We're doing this in remembrance of you. And we come, O Lord God, each and every one of us with open hearts to receive, Lord, the grace that you had to obey, let it be released in each and every one of us by this communion today in the name of Jesus Christ. There is so much blessing. There is so much benefit in obedience. It's unquantifiable. We cannot even fully recount them, and they are everywhere. We have access to profit by obeying your word. We have access to peace and rest and joy and gladness by obeying your word. We have access to dominion by obeying your word. We have access to the blessings of the kingdom, all the inheritances that have been reserved for us in Christ, that are incorruptible, undefiled, and cannot fade away, only through obedience. Therefore, obedience is so important. It is paramount. Let this power be released in each of us by the communion today in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord Almighty, we are grateful to you for counting us worthy to come at this time. We yield ourselves unto you. And we ask, Lord God Almighty, that all the amazing blessings that you have packaged together and spoken and unspoken, that you have released through the communion, your body, which is the bread, and your blood, which is the wine, let them come into us as we are partaking of this communion today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Those who need healing, let them receive healing. In the name of Jesus Christ. Those who need deliverance, let them be delivered. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Those who need wisdom, the light of God, let it shine forth in their hearts. In the mighty name of Jesus. Those who need courage, my Father, my God, and confidence, let it come in Jesus' name. Those who need faith, my Lord and my God, let them receive it in abundance. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Those who need, O Lord God Almighty, a dominion and victory in every area that they may need it, Lord, let them have them in the name of Jesus Christ. Because of the blood of Jesus, let all the blessings that you have purposed to release by that blood be received, appropriated, and tangibly experienced by each and every one of us as we come to this table today. Glory be to your name. We worship you, Lord God. We receive your body with thanks. We receive your blood with thanks. Because your body is broken for us, nothing shall be broken in our lives. Amen. Except the power of the devil. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. We exalt your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please come forward and partake of the table. Glory be to God.
Thank you, my Lord. Thank you for saving me. Thank you, my Jesus, saving me. Thank you. I thank you, my dear Lord, for saving me. Thank you. Thank you, my Jesus. Thank you for dying for me. Thank you, my Lord. Thank you for dying for me. Thank you. Thank you, my Jesus. I thank you, my dear Lord. Thank you, my Lord. Thank you for saving me. Thank you, my Jesus. Thank you, my dear Lord. happy the Son of God is my friend. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God is my friend. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God saved my soul. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God saved my soul. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God saved my soul. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God saved my soul. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm so happy the Son of God saved my soul. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God saved my soul. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm so happy the Son of God set me free. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God saved my soul. Oh, I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God set me free. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God set me free. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy the Son of God set me free. I'm happy, I'm so happy, I'm happy the Son of God set me free.
Amen. Father, we are grateful to you. We exalt your holy name. We are grateful to you that the battle, O Lord God, is over in the name of Jesus Christ. We know that it is the will of the enemy that we disobey so that he can continue to rule in our affairs. But you have said unto us that a person to whom you yield ourselves to obey, that is the one whom we have submitted ourselves to obey. Today, O Lord, we yield ourselves unto you, Lord Jesus, that Lord Almighty, our Father, our God, you will rule in our lives. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let your rule and your reign be total. Give no room, O Lord God Almighty, to another. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Today, O Lord God, your church is sanctified in obedience. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for grafting us in. Thank you, Lord God, for the full restoration. Amen. We bless your holy name. Thank you for, O Lord God Almighty, multitude of testimonies coming, O Lord, as a result of obedience. We worship you, Lord God, for changed lives. We worship you for changed situations. We worship you, Lord God Almighty, for change arising. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's put our hands together for Jesus. Someone worshiping with us for the first time, please come forward. You're worshiping with us for the first time. We want to pray for you. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Please rise up, people of God. Let's pray. Please come forward. Come boldly. Come boldly. It's the house of your Father. Amen. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Please draw closer to me. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let us rise up. Don't be shy. Don't be afraid. Relax. Amen. You're here to be blessed. Glory be to God. Please let us stretch forth our hands to these our brethren. And let us bless them in the name of the Lord. That the blessing may remain upon their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Father, we are grateful to you. We thank you, Lord Almighty, for these families. We worship you, Lord Almighty, for your marvelous grace in their lives. We thank you, Lord, because you are the one that has sustained them hitherto. We give you praise, O Lord God Almighty, in everything that they have seen you, in everything that they have seen your hand, And everything that they have experienced, the power of the Almighty God will give you all the glory. Because we recognize that these things cannot be except by you. Now, Lord Almighty, we recognize also that no matter what has been done in their lives and their affairs, you desire greater things for them. Because you are the God that always desires to see the greater things in the lives of your children. Pour the greater blessings in these families.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Lift them up.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen. Lord God Almighty, refresh them with fresh blessings.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Strengthen them in the Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Banish confusion from their lives.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If there be any of them at the crossroad, wanting to, not knowing which way to turn, my Lord and my God, let the light shine.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You have said there was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came to bear witness. The same came as a witness, to bear witness of that light. My Lord and my God, let this, your children, bear witness of that light.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let them come to positions where they say, I see. This is the way forward. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Remove every barrier.
Amen.
Remove every obstacle.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Lift them out of the ditch.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let the valleys be raised for them.
Amen.
Let the mountains be cleared for
Amen.
Them. Let the mountains become level path before their feet.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let them flourish in the blessing of the Lord. As we have had your word regarding obedience today, my Lord and my God, I pray that you will release the grace of humility in them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
That each of them, O Lord God, will be able to follow you in humility. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That they may be stepping into the blessings.
Amen.
We worship you, Lord God. We give you all the praise.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Good to see you, young man. Good to see you.